Hi everyone, I'm Hannah, an English teacher at Virtually Fluent. Today we are going to be talking about how to better understand and prepare for telephone calls in English. With the massive boom of online streaming services and video conference tools, most of us have some form of video when we are speaking to somebody in English. And when you're watching a video in English or you see somebody in real life, you can watch their mouth, you can see their facial expressions and their hand gestures. It's actually much easier to understand a language in this way. The opposite of this is using telephone calls or microphones or listening to something where you have no visual cues whatsoever in the language. This is much more difficult, and this is what we're going to focus on today. Now, the first thing I want to point out is that most of us don't get enough practice of this form of listening, because when we are studying English, we often watch videos on YouTube, or we watch TV series or films where there is a visual cue in front of us. People don't regularly listen to podcasts or just listen to audios in the background, so we don't have enough exposure to this listening skill. So the first thing I can recommend if you have difficulty understanding English on telephone calls is to put yourself into this situation more often. A few things you can easily do are find some good podcasts online. There are plenty of these available. Listen to the radio in English. Again, there are loads of resources, free resources online that can help you do this. And finally, if you only have video tools available, play the video, but turn it away so you're really focusing on your listening skills instead. And by putting yourself into this situation more, you will rely on your listening skills a lot more, and you'll find it much easier, more comfortable to be in these situations. So now we're focusing on these specific listening skills. How exactly can you understand telephone calls better in English? The first thing is to try and learn some typical telephone phrases. This will make you feel much more confident having something prepared going into a telephone conversation. And most native speakers or other speakers of English will also use these phrases in a conversation, and you can automatically pick those phrases out and start to feel more comfortable communicating over the phone. I highly recommend you research these phrases online. There are some great books that provide full information and lots of keywords and phrases for talking on the telephone in English. Some key things you could learn are how to introduce yourself and ask for somebody over the phone, how to say goodbye at the end of a telephone call, and to listen out for keywords like if the line is engaged or if somebody is busy or you are on hold or they will put you through. All of these keywords will really help you feel more comfortable in a telephone conversation. The second thing is that when you are speaking, you should definitely speak slowly and very clearly. Remember, it's not just the task for you to understand what the speaker is saying, but they also need to understand what you are saying. They also have the same communication difficulties. Speak slower, over-enunciate. At the end of the day, they can't see you. They can't see if you have silly, dramatic faces when you're speaking. So over-exaggerate and really, really speak slowly and clearly so there is an easier flow of communication. My second tip is to not be afraid to ask somebody to repeat themselves or to explain something in a different way. You have no visual cues whatsoever. So the only way that you're going to understand something is if you ask somebody to repeat something or explain in a different way. You can use some polite expressions such as, "I'm sorry, what did you say? I'm sorry, please could you repeat that? I'm sorry, the connection isn't very good. What did you say?" And if you would like them to explain something in a different way, "I'm not sure I understand. Could you possibly repeat that? Could you explain that in a different way, please? An alternative is for you to explain what you think you understand and ask the speaker to confirm whether this is correct or not. Explain the situation. Is this right? Is this correct? Did I understand this correctly? I also recommend sending a follow-up email after the telephone conversation. This might not be necessary for every single English telephone conversation, but just summarise the main points from the telephone conversation, take notes while you're on the phone, and send a summary email and just ask the speaker to confirm whether this was correct or not. This will make you feel more confident that you did understand what the person was saying. And my final tip is to try and prepare yourself as much as possible. So if there is key vocabulary that you need, for example, if you're explaining a document or a report, then prepare this vocabulary before you go onto the telephone conversation. Of course, it is a spontaneous conversation, so you won't be able to use an entire conversation that you've set up in your head, but certainly key phrases, especially if you're presenting or explaining, are very easy to prepare in advance. Just jot them down, highlight them, and then say them in the conversation. This is particularly important if you get sent to the answering machine or you need to leave a message, because you have a very limited amount of time to say this message and you can easily prepare the entire message in English, almost read it off. So the more preparation you have, the more comfortable you should feel on the telephone. So those are my top tips to try and help you understand telephone conversations in English. The final thing is to try and put yourself into this situation as much as possible in order to practice. It is very scary, and not understanding exactly what somebody has said and creating an awkward feeling is a horrible feeling in a foreign language, but you need to challenge yourself for your English listening skills. Try booking an appointment or reserving a table at a local restaurant or booking tickets through the phone. Even ordering a takeout through the telephone, all of these things will push you to use your English speaking. So hopefully those tips will help you feel a little more confident and provide you with more practice for English listening skills without any visual cues. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn notifications on to see lots more videos with top tips to help you learn English on a daily basis. This is Hannah from Virtually Fluent, bringing English to life.